Welcome back, Internet. Today we got an exciting video. I hit up this small liquor store and I found a lot of random things. A lot of these were covered in dust when I pulled them off the shelf. And that's my favorite way to shop. You know, everybody goes to those big box stores, the Specs, the Total Wine, Goody Goody, all the mega stores.
Okay.
But you can't forget, you can't sleep on the mom and pops, man. Because they've got the vintage stuff that people loved. Like, I even came across one that had UV vanilla. Or no, absolute vanilla. But like the original bottle that I liked. Not the new bottle. Like, so they had the frosted glass one.
So, completely different recipe.
Yeah. Yeah. Completely different ownership, different recipe.
Just like not even the same thing.
So I thought it would be nice. I picked up all these random ones from this store because they were 50% off and about to close the whole store. So I took advantage.
Right.
So we got Pumpkin Spice Revel Stoke. And on this channel, we've tried the pineapple. We love that.
That one's good, yeah.
We've got Creme de Banana. Thrilla Vanilla. And, I mean, you could tell this label looks pretty vintage. He's had the store 25 years.
Oof.
And he's probably had this since the beginning. I don't ever remember seeing this before. But I saw the label and I was like, you got to. So I'm going to be putting out a shorts where I went and filmed inside the store.
Nice.
And you're going to see me wiping the dust off some of these bottles just to show you how long they've been on the shelf. And then to finish it up, we've got Uncle Bob's Root Beer Whiskey.
Nice. Oh man, I'm excited for that one. I love root beer.
Root beer flavored whiskey.
And nice.
That's, 35% alcohol by volume, probably the strongest of anything on the table.
That sounds good.
All right, so let's start with pumpkin spice.
Alrighty.
And you know, if this one's good enough, we'll bring it back, and we'll try it with the rest of the Revel Stokes. We'll do a whole montage with that.
Sounds good to me.
So let's see.
Glug, glug, glug. Glug,
glug, glug. Alright, so Revel Stoke Pumpkin Spice Flavored Whiskey, imported Canadian whiskey with natural pumpkin spice flavors.
So, oh, go ahead.
Nothing special on the back.
Yeah, so Revel Stoke is pretty much known for their flavored whiskeys, right? Like, that's their thing, right? I
mean, flavored Canadian whiskey.
Right, so, like you said, that pineapple one, I think I've seen, like, a cinnamon one and stuff like that. Mm.
Yeah, so I think this would go pretty well with, like, Fireball. Like, very cinnamony.
Yeah, it's full of cinnamon in it, yeah. Mm-hmm. Don't really smell any pumpkin in it, though.
Maybe it's just the pumpkin spice. Oh. That's interesting.
Yeah, I taste the pumpkin spice in that.
I don't know how I feel about that. You know, if I had that with eggnog, I'd probably be good.
Yeah. I was going to say, it reminds me.
Because you got like nutmeg or something.
It reminds me of a pumpkin spice coffee creamer.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what it reminds me. I know you don't drink coffee much, but
yeah,
I've had it, especially now with the holidays just passing, and that's what it tastes like, basically. It's not bad. It's just, you know, it's just got that taste to it. But yeah. In an eggnog, yeah, definitely.
With an eggnog, definitely with pumpkin spice, you're good.
Smooth, too.
Smooth, yeah.
Not I mean, that much of a burn.
No, that was good. I mean, it was good. But I don't think I could drink that straight.
Yeah, definitely as a mixer. I mean,
like, that's not my cup of tea for a flavor to drink straight. I would drink that mixed eggnog, or I'm sure maybe kind of like a twist on White Russian.
Oh, I was kind of thinking that too. Yeah,
coffee, cream, something cream whiskey.
Based. Yeah, something cream based. Definitely, mm-hmm. That'll be good. Yeah, that with some like maybe some. Some Baileys, maybe?
Yeah.
Maybe make something like that?
Little Baileys, and then you could even throw a shot of Kahlua, so you have like a spiked pumpkin spice coffee.
Right there, recipe.
Yeah. Throw that in the like cocktail, that. Right. Write it down.
Trademark coming soon for the recipe.
Yeah. All right, so...
Rob, all right, I got a confession. I want to save this one for last, because...
You're holding this on a pedestal, or
yes,
what?
Yes.
All right, slide this down.
This is first time, guys. We're moving this one down.
Okay.
So we'll go with these, and I'll tell you why later.
All right. So, Thrilla Vanilla.
All
And at first, I wasn't going to buy this one. Mm-hmm. And I actually had to go back to get it after I left. It was just like, I couldn't see what I would use it with. But then I was like, that bottle is so cool. So it looks so vintage. Like, it. I just needed to get it.
Yeah.
So what this one is it's from a very popular schnapps company.
Yeah, I was going to say, that sounds familiar. I've seen...
them, they have Hop Dam and Creme de Mint and all those other schnapps.
That's what it is, Hop Dam. Okay.
This one, French vanilla liqueur. And I'm not going to lie, I kind of got the idea, you take this and you make old fashions with it. Like, instead of using your own simple syrup, use French vanilla.
Okay.
With the whiskey and the orange bitters.
Okay.
Kind of put a twist on it.
Yeah, I can see it. So this one is, I just seen it when you were pouring it. It's only 15%, so 30 proof.
Yeah.
It's not that strong.
No.
Yeah, it's not that strong.
Yeah,
so
that's
I could see that replacing something like that. You know, you're not going to be adding too much of the...
Yeah, so instead of watering it down by adding simple syrup and then sugar, you know, I've had some where they use like turbinado sugar, so it kind of has like a more smoky vanilla.
Yeah, the brown sugar type.
But this, I could see this going pretty good like that.
Well, let's see what it tastes like.
New fashion. The Thrilla old fashion.
That smells like vanilla. That's got a real good vanilla smell.
Oh, my God. You know, that's like drinking like ice cream liqueur.
Holy hell.
Like if they branded this as Bluebell vanilla liqueur, they would sell dozens. Dekuyper? Call me. I don't even know how to say this name. How do you say that?
Dude, I think you just like pronounced it right on the first time. That's what Dekuyper.
Call us, sponsor us. We'll connect you with Bluebell. We'll make Bluebell French Vanilla Thrilla Vanilla.
That is good.
And re-release this. You guys are missing out.
Wait, is it no longer available?
I've never seen this before in my life.
To be honest, I've never seen it either. Maybe they rebranded it under a different name.
Another company?
No. I mean, because Dekuyper has all kind of... but this is not a schnapps.
They're a lot of schnapps. This just says French vanilla liqueur.
Man, that was good.
Yeah.
That was real good. Like, zero burn, obviously, because it's, like, not that fruit.
So sweet, yeah.
Not even, like, super sweet, though.
Oh, you know what? I'm jumping the gun here, but I could already see a mixed drink with this.
Mm-hmm.
Uncle Bob's root beer whiskey with a shot of French vanilla liqueur, a root beer float.
Like that one?
Yeah. Like, maybe do it in a shooter glass.
We're doing it here, folks. Expect that one. That one's coming. Oh, man. Yeah.
Well, let's taste this first before we make that.
Okay.
I mean, I'm jumping the gun.
But, yeah.
With another drink recipe.
Thrilla Vanilla. If you guys somehow find this somewhere in one of your local mom and pop shops, yeah, pick that up. Dust and all. Get it.
Look at the dust under this lid.
Rob, we're safe to drink these, right?
Yeah. Dude, it's alcohol. Like, why would we not be safe to drink it?
Sure.
Get that ring of dust, though.
I've been sitting for a while, too.
So, little story. After the hurricane, Harvey, or Ike, I don't remember which hurricane we've had here.
Harvey's the latest one.
After the latest hurricane, I stumbled across this liquor store.
Mm-hmm.
And at the time, I was trying to find just old bottles of Tuaca.
Ah, I remember you telling me.
And because at the time, they just had the ones from Brown Foreman, were not good.
Mm-hmm.
And I could post a picture of that. And this liquor store had the 1.75 liter original Tuaca with this thickest layer of dust. And it was on the top shelf, and I walked into this liquor store, and it was like a year or two after the hurricane, and it just smelled like the hurricane. All right, I'm not gonna lie.
Like, smells like water in here.
And I go, man, this, and the lights weren't working at the time. It was dark, and I'm just around with my camera flashlight, and I see on the top shelf this bottle covered in dust. I'm like, that's my baby up there. That's my Tuaca. And the heavens just kind of... And then I took it and I wiped it and I go, oh, the original label.
Oh my god.
Alright, let's give this buddy a shot. Ooh.
Nice.
Smells like root beer.
Ooh. Like, oh man, that smells like the root beer candies.
Yeah.
I love root beer. I'm a huge root beer. So anything root beer flavored, even if it's artificial, oh my god, give it to me.
Hopefully this doesn't taste like root beer toothpaste.
I like that too. That's a thing.
I mean, some people think root beer tastes like toothpaste. Just kind of like some people think cilantro tastes like soap.
I know. I've heard that's a biological thing. Some people really do taste that as soap.
Yeah.
But, man, that smells so good. Really? Cheers, dude.
That's not bad.
Where's it at? Where's it at? Right before I lose it. It tastes like...
Is that like an A&W?
Yes.
Is it like a name brand?
A&W has a candy? Who has a root beer candy?
I don't know.
Guys, let us know in the comments if you know what I'm talking about. There's a candy that tastes like root beer that's shaped and molded like a root beer...
Like the barrel?
Like a barrel.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's exactly what that tastes like. That's good.
Can we try the shot now before we move to the banana? Yeah. All right, let's do it here first.
We're gonna do
the root beer whiskey or what do we call it?
Vanilla flow, root beer
cream
float.
Soda.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so let's get enough in there.
Yeah, like half and half, half and half.
Okay. That's vanilla good. Cream soda. Root beer float.
Root beer float. Yeah, root beer float.
All right, root beer float cocktail, right? 2022.
2022. The last 2 days of the year. We'll put the trademark below.
Ooh-wee. All right, that looks pretty good. Okay.
All right. So,
how's it smell? Does it smell like?
Let me mix it a bit.
I hope this is.
I smell the vanilla. I smell the root beer. I have high hopes for this one. What do you think?
Okay. I feel that.
Smells good, right?
I hope we have a upcoming sponsorship with Uncle Bob's and Dekuyper.
Come on, guys. We can push you back into relevancy.
I mean, we are the most relevant drinking channel on the internet.
Who's doing it like us, right, guys?
Or at least that's what we say.
Yeah, that's what we think in our minds.
That's what we call ourselves. With the vanilla, bro. Wow. That is another level right there. Wow.
If you're 21, if you drink alcohol, here's your dessert. Oh my god.
Wow.
That was good.
Yeah.
That was good.
Wow. I'm going to have to write that one for the book.
That was good.
Yeah. End of 2023, we have a book coming out. So.
Be on the lookout. So zero burn, personally.
Yeah, no, that's
zero
smooth.
Burn. So don't worry about the burn, but get the lore of the flavors.
And it's not toothpaste.
No.
If it was vanilla toothpaste, I'd tell you.
Yeah.
That's vanilla root beer float.
The vanilla is there. This is great flavor. I know I said this tasted like a candy, but it's still, it's got a good root beer flavor. Like, man, it's so good.
Yeah, it had that root beer candy flavor.
Yes, but
it was also very, it's still whiskey.
Yes. Oh, yeah, definitely could taste
it. It was strong, but it wasn't like a burn.
No.
But then when you add the vanilla to it, it mellows that out even more and brings that to another level.
That was great.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, you ready for banana?
Let me do a little backstory.
Okay.
All right, guys. So, similar to another video we actually recently did, that'll be linked down below, we had, I had tried a banana liqueur over at Rob's, And at the time, I was maybe like, I think I was like 21, 22. So it was about, you know, whatever, 5, 6 years ago. It was like the greatest thing ever. Like, I remember it wasn't even for a video. It was just like, we were just, at, it was at. So the, I was telling a story about the banana drink and then the video cut off. So now we had to drink it again.
Oh no. So terrible. So you were saying that we were drink. I had given it to you at my house.
Yeah.
And
so
it wasn't for a video.
So I had this about 5 years ago, right? I was about 21 years old, and Robert put me on. He's like, yeah, take a shot of this. Right? It wasn't for a video. It was just for fun. It was like after we recorded some of our older stuff. He's like, yeah, try some of this. You know, it's pretty good. I'm like, all right, whatever. Took a shot of it, and I was like, tastes like banana Laffy Taffy. I was like, what the hell is this stuff, man? I remember because I was only just taking little shots of everything. But after I took it, I was like, can I get some more? Can I get some more of that stuff? It was amazing. Like, and it was the greatest stuff ever. And ever since then, every time I'm at the liquor store, I'm like, hey, Rob, is this? I'll send him a picture. I'm like, is this the one that we drank that one time? He never gives me a straight answer. Anyways, yeah, so I'm excited about this. I love banana flavored. And stuff's good, by the way. Well, we're gonna see how it tastes like right now, right? Here's the taste test.
Yeah, yeah. So, all right. So there's like three major creme de banana flavors, and there's Dekuyper, which is the same as Thrilla vanilla.
Yeah.
There's another one that I don't remember the brand for whatever reason, and then there's this one, Hiram Walker. They do a lot of
flavored drinks.
Yeah.
So what's the percentage on this one?
This one is 15% alcohol by volume.
Eh, not too strong.
So, I got a 1 liter of it for half price, $12.99. So I paid $6.50 for that.
You can't beat it.
Yeah.
I mean,
don't be afraid of your mom or pops. I mean, I paid $6.50 for that. I paid $8.50 for this. I paid $6.50 for this. I paid $8 for that one. So, I mean, for like $30.
Four bottles.
I mean, and these three are a liter each. So, I mean, you're going to get a large amount of alcohol.
Yeah. It's like thrifting. You know, you got to go out there, guys, and see what's at your local stores. And
don't be afraid of the mom and pops. Don't be afraid of sun fading liquor bottles. Oh, yeah. But let's try this one.
See what this is like. Let's give it a sniff test first. All right. Smells like banana. Smells like banana.
You know? You know what this reminds me of? Banana pudding.
Yes. It's exactly what it tastes like.
If I could find an alcohol that tasted like a vanilla wafer or a graham cracker, I'd be set. I'd have banana pudding shots all the time.
Yeah, this... Oh, man. That the banana flavor in there, it's there. It's like they
this tastes like
they
actual
it.
Bananas, not like Laffy Taffy banana like the other one.
Right, you're right, but it's still good.
Yeah,
it's still good. It tastes like this was juiced with bananas or something. That makes no sense, but
yeah, it doesn't.
But you know what I mean. Like,
yeah,
it's
yeah,
like
it's,
someone like
someone took an actual banana and just and put it in that bottle.
That's good stuff. That's good stuff, guys. Yeah, I love it. That's good.
So, yeah. I mean, that's the most natural banana flavor liquor I've ever had. Like, this is literally creme de banana.
This banana flavor is amazing. We got another special guest. Same special guest,
but little baby. That's it. Cause I don't even like plantains like
get
that.
Get a little lower so the camera can see.
Little lower, cause I'm a little bit too high in
He's
stature.
He's too high, bro. He high, but not yet.
I'm too high in stature, so you know.
Go ahead, bro.
Oh God.
Take a shot. Banana. It tastes like an actual.
I don't even eat real bananas because.
Yeah, it's for diabetes. You can't have it.
Diabetes.
Yeah. I mean, you gotta take care of yourself.
Yeah, don't listen
Health
to the
Health as
doctors.
Well, but
yes,
you know.
Right. One time for the one time.
Not too bad. That's actually not bad.
Alright, guys. You heard it there. Sorry. I'm drunk. Let's see how this tastes.
Sure. Let's take another shot. It's been a while since I had it.
Yes, sir. It's been a minute.
All right. Never gets old, man.
I could drink that out of a straw.
You know, there was a period of time where I was taking that banana liqueur, and I was trying to make all these different shots. Best.
What? Where was I?
And I was trying to find different liquors that could make that, like, graham cracker crust, vanilla wafer kind of cookie, and I could never find anything. And I ended up trying to do, like, Fireball in this, Hot Damn in this. But, man, with this banana flavor,
you don't need it.
No.
This, oh, guys.
This is just banana cream pie.
Put this.
But without the pie crust.
All right. Get a cup.
Maybe some almond something.
That and some peanut butter whiskey. A banana peanut, because it's not, the banana is not overpowering. I feel like that would be great for the next content.
Peanut butter, banana. All right, so if we don't drink this whole bottle, we'll make Elvis.
It's not overpowering.
Elvis?
Yeah. Peanut butter and banana.
Two things. One, the bottle's gone tonight. Two, what's in Elvis?
Well, our Elvis shot would be one part screwball, one part this.
I'm ready. I'm ready for that.
Do you have any screwball? Okay, next time on the Buck Fumbled videos, we drink the Elvis shot.
Won't be with this bottle, but this one's done for.
Yep, but make sure you like, subscribe, and check out your local liquor stores for more
You know. Check out your
mom and pop shops for the win. Don't go to the main brand. Don't go mainstream. Support your local followers and supporters who supply you with the best merchandise for the best price.